everyone, and welcome to another tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to add textures to your illustrations in Photoshop Touch. And now what the techniques I'm going to show you are basically just using the filters built into Photoshop Touch. You can also add textures to your illustrations and your artwork if you import actual photographs that you take of textures. But the techniques I'm going to show you today are basically just using the in-house filters and effects inside of Photoshop Touch. All right, so what I'm going to do is start off in Adobe Ideas, and I'm going to select this illustration I created in Adobe Ideas of Bizarro. And what I want to do is I want to add some textures to this illustration. So I'm going to go ahead and tell it to save to the album. And what this will do is save a copy of this image onto my iPad. And now what I can do is launch Photoshop Touch. And then what I can do is go ahead and import this illustration that I just exported of Adobe Ideas into Photoshop Touch. And we'll just select this and go ahead and import. And so now we have the illustration in. And let's go ahead and duplicate this several times. And the reason why I want to duplicate this is because some of the effects and filters are kind of permanent effects instead of like smart effects and filters that you see in Photoshop. So what I'm going to do here is click on the effects tab, and let's go ahead and start with the halftone effect. And you can see this makes it that kind of old comic book looking effect with the little dots for shading. Now I don't want black, I kind of want to make it like a little bit of a darker red, and this will kind of give it a little bit of a vintage kind of color tint to it. And now you can see it applies it to my layer, and I can change the blending mode from just normal to overlay. Or if I want, I can try multiply different selections. And then I'm going to bring down the opacity just a little bit because I don't want it to be really strong. I just want it to be kind of a nice subtle effect. And then now I'm going to go ahead and just go ahead and merge the visible. You notice how I turned off the dots on the other layers. And what happens is by doing this, it merges those halftone effects into one image. And now I'm going to drag the other layer that was at the bottom above it. This is just my extra copy, and I'm going to apply another effect. And this is going to be, I'm going to add some grain. And this is going to give it a little bit more texture. And let's see here, just kind of bring up the contrast here. Now, of course, you know, when you're doing this with your illustrations or photographs, feel free to basically experiment until you get the effect that you're looking for. Okay, so now I have this grainy image. What I'm going to go do is tell this to invert the image. There we go. And now I'm going to change my blending mode, let's say, to linear dodge. I'm going to take the opacity down just a little bit here. And now when I zoom in, you can see we almost have this kind of like canvas looking texture to my illustration. So we got some nice texture going on so far. Let's go ahead and merge the visible now. So we're going to merge the halftone dot that we combined before with now this noise. And now I'm going to go ahead and add some curves or level adjustments here. And I want to kind of give it a little bit more of a washed out look, a little bit more kind of faded, like it's been worn a little bit. And let's see here. Now let's go ahead and you can see we have our nice halftone effect and some noise filter effects going in there. So now we have some texture. Let's go ahead and take it a step further. I'm going to basically go up into the effects and let's add, there we go. And I'm going to change my scratch color. You can see here's this canvas, kind of looks like a little canvas looking texture. Here we go. And so now you can see a little bit of these worn out edges onto my illustration and everything like that. And well, that's it. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial and thank you for watching. And as always, if you have any questions, feel free to email me and have a great day.